Because you asked for it. From around the corner, from around the nation, from around the world. Yes, it's Worldwide Magazine. Winner of hundreds of group beauty awards and seen in dozens and dozens of foreign countries via satellite. Hi, this is PEP saying that we got a great show today, so don't go away. Don't touch that dial. You'll be making the biggest mistake of your life. Today on Worldwide Magazine, there are more stars than in the heavens as we present another All-Star Gala Edition featuring Big Daddy. Steve Bailey. Miss Kathy, Watt Davis, Marty, and Marty's brother Mark, the professional announcer, and Denise.
No more hangers!
Yes, the drama, the spectacle, the pageantry, all for you. A cavalcade of unbelievable entertainment. A true spectacle.
Come and be the dancing queen on the avenue. I'm taking you to 42nd Street.
So sit back, relax, and enjoy another edition of Worldwide Magazine. You know, I've been meaning to get the copyright clearance for this movie. I just haven't gotten around to it yet. I gotta do that tomorrow morning, first thing. Well, we're down here, Lee May. Well, it's some old coot that happens to be wandering by. How you doing, pal?
Fine, fine.
What'd you do before you retired?
I was a druggist in Lima for 20 years.
Oh, you were a pharmacist? Hey, you got any pills? You got any pills left over from the old pharmacy?
No, they closed up and we threw out all the pills.
Oh, you threw them all out? Isn't that a shame? You know, there's kids in Europe that have a pill shortage that wish they could get some pills, because, you know, there's a shortage of pills over there, and you threw them out, huh?
I didn't know anything about them, sir. I'm sorry.
Oh. And how old are you?
I'm 72.
72? You look great. You don't look a day over 69.
Good. Thank you, sir.
Oh, Pete! It was Pete! Help me, Pete. Help me. It was terrible. He had 1,000 hands.
You know, Kathy, I've had a lot of police training, and I'm real good at identifying people and finding people that, you know, perpetrated crimes. Maybe if you describe the man to me, I'll be able to figure out who it is.
It was terrible! It was terrible! He had a cold coat on, oh, and a plaid jacket, and the plaid just kept pulsating at me.
What color hat?
Brown. It was brown. Oh, I'll never forget that brown. And he had a cane.
He had a cane?
Hit me with it. Oh, it was terrible. It was awful. Oh, my God. And he had this vicious dog. Oh, my God. It was snapping at me. It was terrible. It was trying to eat me alive. Oh my God, I'll never be the same. Never be the same. Never.
I wish I could help you. I just can't figure out who that could be. Now it's time for another trip on the bi-state bus system with Marty and Marty's brother Mark.
Excuse me, sir, where are you going at?
To Gravois, to Auto Shack.
Well, that's a good place to go. Good place to buy auto parts. Auto Shack. You know, I go there myself. I go there all the time. Especially since I work on cars, so you gotta have some parts. So I'm bussing today, and the man's going Auto Shacking today, so that's a good combination.
Another one rides the bus. Another one rides the bus. Ow! Another one rides the bus.
So anyhow, you're going to Auto Shack, right? Yeah, I just went over and bought some parts. Friday it was. I bought about $20 worth of stuff. They got great buys over there.
Another one rides the bus. Another one rides the bus.
Saturday night, I was on the crown of that bus, and they got the smoking and everything over on, can't think of this, over by Anheuser-Busch, and started smoking. The whole bus filled up with smoking, people had to get off the bus and wait outside in the cold. We waited about an hour and a half for the next bus. That was terrible. And, people was coughing, and it was just filled up with smoke all over the place. So we stood out there in the cold, then when we got back on the bus, that bus was gone.
Hey guys, being we're here, let's go into the police station and cause trouble. Come on, let's go.
He'll throw us out.
No, those are fun-loving guys. They have a good sense of humor. Miss, there's a police station over here. Thank you.
Police headquarters now.
Howdy. You have any wanted posters?
Wanted posters?
Yeah, I need a wanted poster, like the top 10 criminals. Like that, yeah.
Here's one.
You got what? Oh, do you have
one?
Can I have a big one?
What?
Can I have a big one?
I don't have none to give you.
Can I have that one? That's an old one, isn't it? That's an old one, isn't it?
Well, they ain't all arrested.
Well, what is that from? That's from those. I remember those criminals. Those are the same ones you were looking for last spring. They're the same criminals. You think that, you know, like on a top 40 radio station, you know, they have the top 10.
Right.
They're like, you know, Michael Jackson will be number one for a while. And then like, he'll, you know, go down the chart and they'll be like, you know, somebody else will come up.
You have to pay him again?
No.
I'm going to pay him again.
I don't think you have.
Because I'm going to be counted as a passenger. Every time I get on this bus, I'm going to make a book for him.
Yeah, boy.
That's it.
Another one rides the bus. And another comes on, and another comes on. Another one rides the bus. Hey, he's gonna sit by you. Another one rides the bus. There's a suitcase poking me in the ribs. There's an elbow in my ear. There's a smelly old bum standing next to me. He hasn't showered in a year.
Oh, I don't know. ride bus. Another one ride bus.
And another comes on, and another comes on. Another one ride bus. Hey, he's gonna sit by you.
Ask me about that on the Arsenal bus about 10 years ago. I remember that one. It was a snowstorm. He's the boss over the wheel. I remember that. Just because he was 4 minutes early. I mean, the Arsenal bus, I think, is one of the shortest in the system, I believe. It's 15 minutes from Kmart up on Gravoy back over to Anheuser-Busch. I see no room for improvement there. They don't get no people on Sundays. They had the bus operate on Sunday a long time ago. Well, it's been almost a year now. And they cut the bus off on Sunday, and for a while we thought they was going to cut it off on Saturday. But the bus company thought that was a foolish idea, so they had reduced service on Saturday. I'm still glad it's around, but it's not so good on Saturdays anymore. Bus don't run on Sunday, period. Watch your step.
Another one rides the bus. Another one rides the bus. Oh, another one rides the bus. Hey, hey! Do you think about the Dutchie Dottie? Give me booty, 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 booty,
booty, booty, booty, booty, see, I usually keep my, is it still on? I usually keep my, right hand here on something or the back of the seat. I was riding the Page Record Center bus I was talking to you about last Thursday when the 5 inches of snow fell. He was the first one on the bus, and here I come on the bus. I show my pass, and then you know how I put my hand behind here. It's primarily to have something to hold on to in case the bus driver has to make a sudden stop. He said, would you mind not putting your hand behind my back? Can you believe that?
You know, talking about these Allman cheeseburgers, I got my opinion. You say you pay $2.50 for a hamburger. Guess how many rides you can actually take on a bus? I got this calculated, so that's almost a good 4 bus rides I know of. So that means you can go 2 times downtown and back from your location out from the out to the city limits.
2 locals
and 1 leader. So that's talking about a pretty good bus ride. That's more than your values were. That's more money to your dollar. Get some more transportation. That's what it's really all about. Bi-State is going your way. Sure are. That's the story behind it.
Bi-State, going your way. 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 Bi-State, going your way.
Look out, brother. Tell me all about it, brother. Is you ready? Is you ready?
Well, here we are at the 7-Eleven, Big Daddy. Now, Big Daddy, I see you want to buy a 6-pack of beer.
or do you want to buy a 12-pack?
It's kind of hard to make up my mind because over here there's a sign that says a 6-pack is $2.79.
Uh-huh, that doesn't sound like a bad deal.
It's a good deal, and then the next price is 12-pack is $5.79. Now, maybe I can't add because I did go to public school, you know. But
didn't you? Wait a second, pal. Didn't you go to the Jackson School of Welding?
Yeah, exactly. Anyway, it seems to me that I'd be paying a little bit cheaper price if I bought 2 6-packs and buying a 12-pack. I can't figure that out.
Well, so 1 6-pack is $2.79.
Right.
But then a 12-pack is
$5.79. Right.
So it's, let me see, it's 21 cents more to buy
a 12-pack. Yeah, I guess that's for the cardboard and stuff,
can
I guess.
Wait a second.
Hey, what's this guy's deal?
Who are you?
Name's Frank Jamel. I work over at 7-Eleven there. I'm the manager.
So you're the manager of 7-Eleven?
Yeah. What can I do for you guys?
Well, listen, taking pictures
of our building over there. That's against our corporate policy.
Well, let me ask you something. This, my friend here, Big Daddy, was going to buy, he drinks a lot of beer, and he was going to buy a 6-pack or a 12-pack of Busch. Now, we see that the 6-pack is $2.79, but the 12-pack is $5.79.
Yeah, that's what the sign says.
So it's 21 cents more to buy one 12-pack than it costs to buy 2 6-packs. Why is that?
I don't know. This is South St. Louis, you know. People down here don't necessarily.
A lot more 12 packs than you are 6 packs,
yeah,
aren't you?
Yeah, as a matter of fact, yeah, everybody's getting quite the deal that way. You know, that everybody knows when you buy, like, you know, bigger jars of peanut butter. Like, I get 5-gallon tub of peanut butter. I get a lot better deal than buying them little bitty jars.
That squid Terry Riley again. Hey, what are you doing on the street out here? I've been running to you all over.
I'm gonna go over there and give me some beer, 6-pack.
Get some beer. Let me give you a little bit of advice. They got Busch on sale over there, and the 12-pack is a real good deal, all right?
In another wonderful spot here in beautiful South St. Louis, where we're going to tell you some more interesting facts about this wonderful town. It's my kind of town, South St. Louis. My kind of town. Ah, shut up, you. Okay, so we got some real good stuff we're gonna do right now, and what's the matter? Kathy, what happened?
I was just walking along, minding my own business, going to the 7-Eleven, and this guy came up, and he started bothering me. He pulled me in the bushes. It was terrible. Oh!
That's terrible. That's terrible. You know, I've had a lot of police training, and maybe if you describe the man to me, I can figure out who it is.
He had this turban on his head. It was like a Van Dyke beard and this mustache and a big mole right here. He looked like the Ayatollah. I think it was the Ayatollah. And he kept slapping me with his turban. He was slapping me left and right. It was terrible. I'll never be the same. Oh.
I wish I could help you. I just can't figure out who that could be. Now there's the Diamonds Restaurant. Now you're driving on Highway 44, you see miles and miles of signs. Only 300 miles to the Diamonds. That's right, only 200 miles. Oops, you just missed the Diamonds. Go back 10 miles. Like it's some sort of special place. The food really stinks, it really does. And see, this is like a place for tourists and truck drivers. I was a tractor trailer truck driver for a period of time, and the thing about it is that, well, you're kind of a captive in there. There's only certain places that you can go in that have, you know, big parking lots. So they got you by the you know what. So they always charge more than other restaurants. And like the first thing you walk in there, you're just get your foot through the front door, and there's some lady named Madge pouring a cup of coffee, whether you want it or not. I never wanted any coffee. You couldn't, you know, it's kind of mandatory. You have to drink coffee there. Denise?
What, Pete?
Now, didn't you used to stay at a lot of truck driver places back before, you know, we met?
No, you're thinking of somebody else.
Now, didn't you used to hang out at a lot of truck driver places?
No.
You weren't a hash slinger? You weren't a waitress at one of those places?
No.
I thought you were. Didn't you say you were?
No, you're confusing. No.
Wasn't that with your second husband, Otis?
No.
Didn't you work there when you were a second husband?
No.
Denise, didn't you have the wedding with your third husband at that restaurant?
Not that I can remember, Pete.
Tyrone?
No.
Well, whatever happened to Tyrone?
I don't know. He just took off.
Restaurant. It's my favorite place in all of St. Louis to
eat. I like this place too.
It's such nice people come here. Boy, oh, what's this? What do you got here?
Thank you
very much. Jesse Jackson.
Thanks.
Jesse Jackson, all right. Punch number 30.
I'm punching. If you punch me again, I'm going to punch you real hard.
Yeah, we're going to the original restaurant. Hey, wait a second. Don't I know this guy? Who's this guy over here? How you doing? How you doing? Nice to see you. Who are you?
Bill Sanders.
Well, Bill, what are you doing, Bill?
Oh, just walking around.
What do you do for a living, Bill?
I'm a laborer.
Oh, laborer? You work for Handy Andy? Handy Andy Labor?
Oh, no, sir.
Which labor company do you?
Actually, I'm an actor.
An actor?
Actor, singer, amateur.
Okay, well, look. We're going to have a Bill's your name, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, Bill, do some acting. Okay.
Hi there.
Talk louder.
Hi there. My name's Bill Sanders. I am an actor. I don't know much acting, but I am an actor. Thank you.
That's great. That's really good.
Yay.
We're always considering new people for the show, and we're going to be giving you some very serious consideration.
Let's get in the original and eat.
Come on. A lot of things are happening so far. We haven't even been in the restaurant.
Get the door for you.
Yeah, okay. That was another great meal right here at the original restaurant, my favorite restaurant.
It was great. I'm going to have some more while you're talking to Nellie, as a matter of fact.
And we're right here once again with one of my favorite people, the owner of the original restaurant, Big Nellie. Even though I guess you're not that big anymore, you've been losing weight, huh?
Yeah.
You look good.
Thank you.
How much did you lose?
46 pounds.
How'd you do it?
And she did anything I wanted.
Hey, you know how she did it. She was on the Big Daddy's Weight Watchers program.
That's right. Well, we were talking about that earlier, that Big Daddy has a new Weight Watchers program, and it's worked wonders for him.
Right.
And with this diet, you can eat all you want, anytime you want, any kind of food, and you have to do no exercise, right? It's something. Yeah. What's the secret? How are you able to lose weight this way?
It's a secret. I can't tell you.
Okay, it's worked wonders for Big Daddy. So, what's new at your restaurant, Nellie?
What's good at the restaurant?
Well, I know. Everything's good at your restaurant.
Everything's good.
What's new?
Coffee, steak, short ribs.
Oh, love those short ribs.
Chicken.
Love that chicken.
Pork chops.
Love those pork chops.
Turnip greens.
Love those turnip greens.
Sweet potatoes.
I like them, too.
Black-eyed peas.
Got it all here.
Yeah, they got it all here. Man, this is a great place. What's your address on Olive?
2217 Hours.
Right, and we're just east of Jefferson, okay? We're in the heart of the edge of downtown.
Yes, that's where we're located. That's the heart of the edge downtown.
Right, and if you want to get this kind of food, there's only one original. It's the original, and it's the only one.
Ask what the hours are that they're open.
When are you open?
The hours is from 7 to 8.
Seven to eight. You only open 1 hour a day, so you better come quick.
7 to 8 a.m.
Oh, 7 a.m. to 8 p.m.
Or whenever you run out of food. Didn't you say something about that?
Yes, whenever I run out of food.
And of course, the nights that Big Daddy comes to eat here, they might close a little bit earlier than normal, right?
Yes. Yes, because he eat up all the food.
Beans and cornbread. Beans and cornbread.
Here at the original restaurant, where we've secretly replaced the fine coffee they normally serve with Smolger's instant recaffeinated coffee, let's check with the customers and see what they think of Smolger's.
Hey, what do you want?
What do you think of that fine coffee they're serving here today, sir?
I haven't tasted it yet, but let me check it out.
That's terrible. That's the worst coffee I've ever tasted. Where's the real coffee here?
What's going on here? That's Smolger's.
I hate Smolger's. I want the new coffee. I want the real coffee. They always serve with the original. It's my favorite restaurant. And the coffee's always great. What are you geeks doing trying to change it? What's wrong with you? I hate that.
Beans and cornbread. Beans and cornbread. Beans and cornbread.
Beans and cornbread had a fight. Beans, beans knocked cornbread out of sight. Beans. Cornbread said, now that's all right. Beans. Meet me on the corner too.
Japan?
Yeah.
You're visiting here?
Yeah.
Oh, really? How do you like it? How do you like it so far?
Yeah, very good.
You like it? You got a camera with you? Take pictures?
Yeah.
Uh-huh. You're going to take... what do you do in Japan? But you don't work for Sony, do you?
No.
No, okay. Thank you. Have a nice time. On behalf of everybody in St. Louis, I want you to have a real good time. Appreciate it. You have any problems, you give us a call. Hey, Marty, how come you're not going to the telephone today?
Well, the thing of it is, Pete, I got this so-called thing called my own telephone. You know, I got these, all my little brothers, you know, especially my big brother, Mark. You know, I got my own collection agency. We're going to do my own collection of money, and,
What kind of organization is this? Now, we've heard of, like, Jerry's Kids and stuff like that. What is this one called?
Well, this is Marty's Telethon.
Like Marty's Kids?
Yeah, for Marty's Kids. See, I got a lot of Marty's running around.
Well, let me ask you, what's the problem that Marty's, we know what's, like, wrong with Jerry's Kids. Now, what's wrong with Marty's Kids?
Marty's kids are all underprivileged children. They have to be fed healthy like me, see? I didn't get big for nothing, bro.
I mean, they're mentally unhealthy? That's why they're called Marty's kids?
Right, right. They're unhealthy. They have to be big and strong like I am, so I have to take a yearly account for all this stuff that I have to get a collection for. So that's Marty's telethon, especially my big brother, Mark. He's got it.
Is he affected with the same problem you have?
Right. He's addicted with all kinds of stuff like I got in common. Plenty of food. Beans. Bean pie. That's the name of the game, man. Beans. Pie. No preserves no more. Just fresh pies. Kind you shove in the oven. Delicious. Good eating. Pies.
Come on down. Got it. My pants need to dance. So big fine mama, come give me a chance. Hey, hey, hey. Got it. My pants need to dance. So big fine sister, when you make a friend. Come on down. I'm the wonder. I'm a good, fine, loving son of a gun. Come on. Hey. Do ya? Do ya?
We
please, Pete, man. Like, you gotta take me around to these radio and TV stations, Pete. Because I know if you just take me around in your cab, I'll get a job. Problem is, I've been taking these bi-state buses, and I end up in Wallston all the time.
Jim, you know, I don't think it's too productive coming here to Casey on a Sunday afternoon. They're not going to have anyone here to hire you.
Yeah, but Pete, if they had a chance to hear me to introduce a record, there's not a chance that I wouldn't get a job here. I work for the number one rock station in all of Canada, in the entire country. And if they just heard me introduce one song, I'd be on the air almost immediately. Pete, you know, if they were, just give me a chance to, you know, to hear me. I know that I'd immediately get a job right away. I work for the number one rock station of all of Canada, the entire country, and it's natural that I'd work at Casey. Like, if they were to hear me, like, for instance, if I were to...
No, but they're not going to hear you. That's a soundproof window over there. That jockey, he's nobody.
No,
he's a part-timer.
No, they'll...
He's getting paid $4 an hour.
No,
it's a little bit better than McDonald's.
They'll hear me, Pete. Listen to this. Here's John Cougar Mellencamp from Casey 95. See? What'd I tell you?
Any luck at that station there, Jim?
No, Pete, the door was locked.
Well, I mean, I don't think that Sunday afternoon is really the best time to look for jobs.
Yeah, it could be. Most people are home on Sunday afternoons.
Well, have you ever tried going during the week?
Well, you know, I don't have your car to get around in during the week.
Well, I got to work during the week. I can't take people on free cab rides. Jim, what are you taking me to the stupid Amtrak station for? I don't want to go to the... Well, there's nothing here. It's a trailer. It's not even a station.
I got to get a job announcing the train arrivals and departures.
You're going to announce the train arrivals?
Yeah, listen to this.
Wait a second. It's too noisy here.
Train boarding now for Flint, Saginaw, Bad Axe, Albuquerque.
You know, they don't have train announcers anymore.
They don't?
No.
Well, that just fucked me.
Well, Jim, you're making a mistake. You're just wasting my time.
Come on out of here.
What are you doing? I mean,
this is the place. This is the train station.
Well, Watt Davis.
You want to shine?
Watt Davis, Watt Davis? What are you doing here?
We got a thing going down here. You want to shine, don't you? I don't have a
25 cents.
See? What did I tell you, Pete? They use live announcers. Can you imagine how good I'd be with train leaving now for Saginaw, Bay City, Flint, Bad Axe.
What's going on there? They do have a train announcer.
Yeah, there he is right there. Look at that guy making big bucks as a train announcer. Are you the announcer for the trains?
Yeah.
Are you? How long have you been doing it?
I've been with the company 12 years.
I've been announcing trains for about 9 or 10.
9 or 10 years. Big money in announcing trains?
Well, Amtrak pays well.
Do they? They got any jobs open for announcers?
No.
Listen to this. Listen how good I am. Train leaving now for Saginaw, Bay City, Flint, Bad Axe.
What about Cucamonga?
Cucamonga.
That's the one you ended with.
Cucamonga.
Who's that from? Jack Benny or some show like that, I think.
Cucamonga. They always went to Cucamonga.
I'm leaving the professional now. This
hey,
is
Pete.
A waste.
Hey, Pete.
Forget it.
Hey.
Forget it. Oh, my, this is a dreary place, isn't it? It's must be some hotel. What? You
don't want to shine?
No, thanks, man.
What?
I just think we're going to make a living around here.
People that take trains don't get their shoes shined anymore, Watt.
Well, it always has been a shoeshine parlor and a train station. And we can't stop the tradition now. So, come on, old buddy, get a good shine on it. Good old shine boy.
Well, being we're here at the train station, let's see, let's get on a train. Hey, where are you folks going? Where are you going? Where are you taking the train to?
Kansas City, who are you?
Just the guy with the camera.
What about they, huh?
Don't worry about it. Hey, where are you going, lady? Where are you going?
I'm sending my son back to school.
Where does he go? What school?
Central Missouri State University.
Oh, Central Missouri. Awesome. Fine, fine school.
Yes, I know.
That's even better than the University of Guam.
Yes, it is.
That's not much, though.
Yeah.
Hey, where you folks going? Where you folks going? I'm going anywhere. Hi, how you doing? Nice to see you. Where you going?
I'm not going anywhere.
Oh, just standing there. Okay, sure. Yeah. Hey, where you folks going? Where you guys going? Where you going? Hey, where's everybody going? Where's everybody going?
Pete, stop there. Stop right there. Stop right there.
What? You mean you want to go to that station?
Yeah.
Well, they're not going to hire you over there, Jim. Forget it.
No, pull in there, Pete.
Forget it. Wasted enough time.
Is this where Channel 24 is?
Yes.
Is it?
Yeah.
Got any announcing positions for Channel 24 yet?
Huh?
Did you know if they've got any announcing positions at Channel 24?
No, you have to tell them to do these renders.
I'm real good. Real good. Listen to this. This is The Life coming up next on Channel 24. Pretty good, huh? Hot stuff?
You have to tell
them. Are these union jobs or non-union jobs? Union jobs pay a lot better. Well, I guess it's time for me to move back to North Fargo.
I'm so weary and all alone. Feet are tired like heavy stone. Traveling, traveling, all alone. Who will see and who will care of the love that I must bear? Traveling, traveling, all alone.
Well, we hope you're enjoying Worldwide Magazine number 33. Could you believe that? We did 33 shows like this. It's kind of unbelievable. Anyway, we're here at the Putt-Putt Golf Course at Chippewa and the River of Despair. And we're just going to hear and kind of take a look around, see this exciting golf course. And you know, you meet some really interesting people at miniature golf courses. You meet people with miniature brains, actually. But anyway, what's that?
A thousand hands! He must have had a thousand hands. They were all over me. They were a thousand hands. Oh, it was terrible. It was terrible. Oh, it was the worst day of my life. Oh, it was the most horrible thing that ever happened to me. Oh, my God, it was terrible.
Well, you know, Kathy, I've had a lot of police training, and I'm real good at investigations and things like that. Maybe if you describe what happened, to describe the man, maybe I can help figure out who it is.
Well, he had on a checkered outfit, a jumpsuit. He had this big pompadour hairdo. He looked just like Elvis before he died. It was frightening. It was frightening. And then he had this big hamburger, a double decker with cheese and secret sauce, and he was putting his secret sauce all over me. Oh, it was terrible. Help me.
I wish I could help you. I just can't picture anybody that looks quite like that. I haven't seen anybody like that all day. I'm sorry. Now, we're out in front of the beautiful Adams Mark Hotel in downtown St. Louis. We're inside the Sammy Davis Jr. Variety Club Telethon is taking place. And you know, I've worked with Sammy for many years, Sammy and Jerry. And, you know, we've been invited to come up and say hello to Sammy. A lot of beautiful people inside. There's a lot of love. As I've told you, we were here last year. And I'll say the same thing again this year. There's a lot of love inside that building today, ladies and gentlemen. A whole lot of love. And it ain't Led Zeppelin. So Oh, you know, a famous celebrity is supposed to be here. Now, Sammy Davis Jr. has a brother, a long-lost brother, who they haven't seen, he hasn't seen in years. Yeah, shut up. He hasn't seen his brother in years. And could you believe who it is? That's right. It's our own Watt Davis Jr. And Watt and Sammy, they were separated at birth in the orphanage. And, you know, of course, Sammy became Sammy Davis and Watt became Watt Davis Jr. And we've scheduled a reunion today. And, of course, a lot of people are real excited to see this. So we're expecting, we're looking at the limousines. We're waiting for Watt Davis to come in. We haven't seen him yet. Oh, wait a second. What's that over there?
What's the weather like in Vegas this time? Can you get an autograph?
Say, baby,
please, it's
got
for my nephew.
We've been waiting for hours to arrive.
It's for my nephew. He's sick.
Oh, baby.
Have you seen Dino lately? Oh, how's Dino?
Jerry, you know Jerry?
Just an autograph. How's Dino? Have you seen Frank? How was Frank when you were in Vegas? How is he doing? Just an autograph. It's my sick, sick cousin. Please, I just wanted to autograph.
It's
a rare treat for us.
Where's the button?
We saw your show last time we were in Vegas. We thought it was great.
Hey, student, you're from Russia?
She's from South Africa.
You're from South Africa?
Are you
far out?
Well, baby, first, we got to have a thing. I got to ask you something.
What?
For sure, you know?
Okay.
So I want you to free my dog! That all right? So now I'll give you my autograph.
Thanks so much.
Well, what do your parents do down there?
Well, my dad's a bank manager and my mom's a housewife.
Oh, I love your accent. That's great. It's an English accent, I guess.
Sort of, I suppose, South African accent.
Well, you know, there's this guy here, Dana Brown. He's like, he goes on safaris and he makes coffee. And he had a thing about it. He said, South Africa is one of the most beautiful parts of the whole world. Well, there sure are a lot of celebrities at this telephone. Oh, look, it's Marty's other brother and sister over there. Boy, there's a remarkable family resemblance, except these guys look a little bit more intelligent. Let's not get into that.
Do you know who Watt Davis Jr. is?
No.
You seen his review in Vegas when they had the Miss Junior Illinois thing out there? Didn't they have that in Vegas?
I think they did. It's they have, from all 50 states, they have them go to Orlando, Florida this year in September, I think it is. And they compete for the Miss America title, Miss Junior America title.
Yeah, Watt Davis Jr. is going to be the MC of that.
I guess. John Davidson is, though.
Watt John Davidson Jr. and Watt Davis Jr. So Watt, Sammy Davis' junior, other brother, John Davis Jr., and Watt Davis Jr. All three of them is going to be like a triple header of Davis Juniors out there.
Oh,
you the guy that used to make the drinks on the Love Boat?
Uh-huh.
How you doing?
All pretty good.
Are you an exchange student from South Africa, too?
Nope.
You're not, huh?
No, I'm just a clown.
Just a clown here, yeah. Huh? What's your name? Bozo?
No, Sparky.
Sparky. Oh, good, Sparky. Nice to see you, Sparky. Yeah. You're going to make me laugh later on, aren't you?
I
know. Okay.
This is your professional announcer live and on location here at this big charitable event. And we have with us the City of St. Louis coordinator for unsavory and deceptive telethons. Is that right, Herman Schamel?
That's right, Herman Schamel.
And Herman, what is it about this telethon you don't like?
The money they're raising here, it's a joke. It goes to a good cause. The money we like to, you know, the kind of telethons and charities and stuff we like to go toward, you know, like the Schamel Yacht Fund and stuff like that.
Now, the last time I heard about you being involved with a big convention here in St. Louis, it was the Hookers and Pimps Convention. Is that right?
That's right. That was good. We had a heck of a telethon for that one, boy. We raised some good money. And, you know, all that went to a worthy cause, went right into the old bank account. That's where that money went. This is ridiculous. I hate this. They got these kids that, you know, could actually use the money. The money's going to go for a good cause. And, you know, it makes me sick to see that kind of stuff, when all that money could be going toward a new limousine or something.
Fanfare now. Big new total up on the board, Pete. The big tote board.
We got a new total.
$2,018,000.
Hey, sad.
That's great.
That's really sad.
That's great.
You know, that's really sad commentary on our times when people are willing to give up that kind of money to help somebody they don't even know. Yeah.
Oh, now do you remember the old Sweps commercials, Commander Whitehead? Well, there he is. He's one of the many celebrities that are here. Hey, excuse me, Commander? Commander? Aren't you Commander Whitehead? No. Used to be with the Schweppes commercials?
No. The Variety Club tries to help. You can see that this problem is genetic. It is passed on from mother to daughter. And it's one of the many things that the Variety Club Telethon tries to help people with. How long has this problem been in your family genetics for a long time?
Yes, it's hereditary.
Yeah, we kind of figured that. So the Variety Club Telethon has helped you a lot in the past few years?
It hasn't helped us, but you know what?
They pay those major hospital bills when you go in for those new hair transplants. That stuff, I heard that, you know, those hair transplants only last for a few months before they revert back to this.
And the noses, yeah.
Yeah.
The eyelashes.
That's,
you know,
really sad.
Yeah.
But I'm glad to see that, you know, you were able to come down and you know that Sammy is really helping you people out.
This is great. This is great.
Okay, all right. Thanks a lot. We hope you all get better.
Okay.
I hope they find a cure for it.
Cigarette for you, Mr. Davis.
Oh, no, baby. I just can't do it. I just can't do it.
Sign it.
I gotta.
If you sign this,
I gotta. This is a special. This is a special visit here. This is my brother. I'm here to see my favorite brother, Sammy Davis Jr. And I want Davis Jr.
to make it tonight.
If you can let me through, I would be okay.
Just sign this for me.
Look, baby, I don't know whether I'll have time or not, baby. I gotta go. This way the door here. Look, man, we got to. I'm here to see my brother, man. And I am Watt Davis Jr. And he don't know I'm coming. And I'm here to surprise him. So if you let me through here,
you have to surprise him as you go down the hall.
They
open them doors over there.
I'm right, or whether I'm wrong. Whether I find a place in this world or never belong.
I am so mad. I don't know what to do. My brother won't have anything to do with me. So I'm going to have to leave here and maybe write him a letter. But right now, he don't have time to talk to his... Only
only brother, Watt Davis Jr. And we'll be all right. It's not going to be any animosity, but we'll be just like that, baby. Don't you think that? So we're cool. We're cool all the time. Yes, sir. So, for right now, later, Gator. See ya after a while, Crocodile.
Who can take a sunrise, sprinkle it with dew, cover it with chocolate or a miracle or two? The Candyman. The Candyman can. The Candyman can, 'cause he mixes it with love to make the world taste good. Who can take a rainbow, wrap it in a sigh, soak it in the sun and make a groovy lemon pie? The Candyman, the Candyman can.
Bit. I got but a couple of bucks. How much it charged to run me to Wellston?
I got about $12.
Oh, well, could you do that for me until I get my check?
No, you have to catch the bus, so it's coming up there.
Okay, then, my man, sorry. Right.
Okay, where are you from?
Creve-Coeur, Missouri.
Creve-Coeur, how about you?
Creve-Coeur, Missouri.
Oh, you live together?
Just about.
Are you a housewife?
No.
You got kids?
No.
You married?
No.
What's your phone number? You know, the public is looking for new faces.
Oh, really?
It's in the phone book. Are you going to try to fix me up with your daughter?
Yeah, it's in the phone book.
You know, would me say something, you know? Wouldn't you like a nice, outstanding young man coming home, escorting your daughter, knowing that your daughter is safe at night, has a fine, outstanding young man with her?
For sure.
What do you think about Jerry Lewis? You want to meet Jerry Lewis?
No, I don't like him.
You don't like Jerry Lewis?
I'm a reporter, and he's very stuck up and conceited.
Oh, you're a reporter? For who?
For AT&T.
What do you mean? You report what?
I'm a writer for AT&T.
Oh, and you don't like Jerry Lewis?
Nope.
What did he ever do to you?
He's very stuck up and conceited.
He's stuck up and conceited?
I have no use for him. Sorry about that. Let him go back to his Italian first wife.
Oh. He has an Italian first wife?
You know that.
No, I don't know nothing about Jerry.
Don't give me no
whole number. Okay. Well, it's all right. Yeah, goodbye. It's okay. She had fat ankles anyway. Yeah, those ankles, look how fat her ankles are. You can't hardly tell she has ankles. Well, here we are, ready to do, hey, you Hoosier! My God, you know, I haven't really talked about it for a long time on the show, but, I mean, pickup trucks, what a bunch of morons. Guys named Gomer and Fred. Anyway, we're down here ready to do another exciting segment on Worldwide Magazine, the program that you asked for. And right now,
terrible. I couldn't get away.
You know, Kathy, I've had a lot of police training, And if you describe the man, maybe I can figure out who it is.
Oh, you should have seen him. He was this huge, burly guy. And he had this huge mane of brown hair and a huge beard and bushy eyebrows, bushy, and a red plaid shirt, and these suspenders. He kept snapping them at me, very maniacally, scaring me, snapping them. Oh, it was horrible. And these eyeballs, he had these huge eyeballs and these big, big teeth. And he just kept showing me these big teeth. Oh, it was the most frightening experience of my entire life. Oh my God, I'm never gonna be the same.
I wish I could help you, Kathy. I just can't figure out who that is.
Big Daddy!
Oh, he's right.
Big Daddy!
Hey, what's going on? You having a problem?
Yeah, man, I have to put some money in here. Shit ain't done, and I heard that you help people, man.
I'll help you out. Let me get this thing out of here.
Big Daddy!
I'm trying to help somebody. Get out of here. Don't you help somebody.
I'd like to thank Big Daddy, Watt Davis, Steve Bailey, the professional announcer, Miss Kathy, Marty, Marty's brother Mark, and Denise. I would like to say thank you to all these people